Close the Orville actor and producer Seth MacFarlane hopes audiences will embrace the blend of comedy and sci-fi his new Fox series offers August 10th. AFIRA 10 Plus programs worth watching this week. 1. The Orville debut, 8 p.m. Sunday, Fox. This is far from the week's best show. It's big and broad, flawed and far-reaching. But it's the first new show of the broadcast network season. It's also typical of a season in which science fiction will dominate. Seth MacFarlane, producer of Family Guy and more, produces, writes and stars as a captain, in what feels like a Star Trek throwback. The result is an uneasy blend of comedy, drama and action. It's terribly uneven, but admirably ambitious. 2. The Deuce debut, 9 p.m. Sunday, HBO. In the 1970s, Times Square has a ragged collection of schemers. Vincent James Franco runs a bar, reluctantly dealing with mobsters and prostitutes. Candy Maggie Gyllenhaal is a rarity, a pimp-free hooker. Abby Margarita Lavieva is a brainy student who would rather make money. Here is the surge of the porn film industry, done in the lush HBO style, with great visuals and gifted actors, including Franco as both Vincent and his bad news brother Frankie. 3. Football, Thursday and Sunday. Now the pros are ready to take over our TV sets, with NBC games at 5:25 p.m. PT. On Thursday with a preview at 4:30, Tom Brady and the Super Bowl champion New England Patriots host the Kansas City Chiefs 124 in the regular season. On Sunday, the Dallas Cowboys 133 host the New York Giants 115. Sunday also has lots of 10 a.m. PT games and more. Colts 88 at Rams 412 at 1:05 p.m. on CBS, Panthers 610 at 49ers 412 at 1:25 p.m. on Fox. More savor Close Encounters of the Third Kind on its 40th anniversary. Vijaylar Teen Idol returns for 14th year. Vijaylar players shine in timely cabaret. Fox Theater announces upcoming films for Biggie, 8:01 p.m. Mandy, air. In his songs, Biggie Smalls was a tough street thug. In real life, one friend calls him a fun, jokey guy, another says he was well-read. He always had something to make you laugh, his mother says. She was a Jamaican immigrant on her own to raise a two-year-old after his dad left. She worked and put herself through school. Her son started rapping at 12, switched to drug dealing, then switched back. He was the Notorious B.I.G., a rap giant when he was killed at 24.5 America's Got Talent semifinals, 8 p.m. Tuesday and Wednesdays, NBC. After a long build-up, things move quickly. On Tuesday, 11 acts perform and viewers vote. On Wednesday, 5 move to the finals. That also happens next week, giving us the final 10. This week has three singers: Evie Claire, Johnny Manuel, Yoli Mayer, plus a singing ventriloquist and a singing ukulele player. It also has a dancer, a dog act, a comedian, a magician and extreme roller skaters, plus an extra wildcard choice. A ride renaissance began in 1959 at Disneyland in Calif. Walt Disney was traveling in Switzerland on vacation with his family, says Robert Coker, author of Roller Coasters: A Thrill Seeker's Guide to the Ultimate Scream Machines. He sent a postcard of the Matterhorn to his Imagineers and just wrote, "Build this." Photo: Disney 6 American Experience, 8:10 p.m. Tuesday and American Masters, 9:10 p.m. Friday, PBS. The second half of a superb experience rerun finds Walt Disney sputtering. A strike left bitterness. His Magnificent Bambi will slump at the box office. After losing interest in films, Disney rebounded with Mary Poppins in Disneyland. Then a so-so. Masters profiles a key figure. Tyrus Wong's artwork dominated Bambi, but he was fired. He ranged from cards to kites, until his death at 106.7 Snowfall season finale, 10 p.m. Wednesday, FX. Skillfully juggling three stories, Snowfall ends with power punches. It's 1983 Los Angeles and Franklin is bringing crack into his Los Angeles neighborhood, as his mother despairs. Teddy, a CIA agent, is running the Contra cocaine deal. Now a young woman searches for her sister, whom, viewers know, was killed by Teddy's colleague. And as Lucia buries her father, she tries to stop her uncle from taking the drug business. It's a fierce finale. 8. XQ Super School Live, 8 p.m. Friday, ABC, CBS, NBC, and Fox. Four networks and lots of stars link, hoping to pump up emotion for schools and for innovation. There will be comedy sketches, short films and music. Andra Day performs and Jennifer Hudson leads a mega collection that has Sheryl Crow, Sheila E., John Books, MC Hammer and the music groups of Max Weinberg and Yo-Yo Ma. Others will be there, including Tom Hanks, Bill Hader, Miranda Cosgrove and Anna Devia Smith. Sam Heughan as Jamie Fraser in Stutz's Outlander, photo Amy Spinks, Stars Entertainment, LLC 9 Outlander season opener, 8 p.m. Sunday, Stars, rerunning at 9 and 10:30 p.m., and 110 a.m. First, we can catch up on the entire second season that starts at 637 a.m., with a finale at 6:30 p.m., thrusting us into new crises. Claire married twice, to Frank in 1940s England and after inadvertent time travel Jamie in 18th century Scotland. With a hopeless battle approaching, Jamie urged his pregnant wife to flee to modern times. Now we see the battle, its fierce aftermath, and her tenuous life. 10 and more, Sunday. The Miss America pageant is 9 p.m. on ABC, facing the Orville and Dewson Outlander and more. At 9 p.m., Fear the Walking Dead returns on AMC. At the same time, a new Top of the Lake tale starts a three-night, eighth-hour run on Sundance. While tackling a murder mystery, Robin Elizabeth Moss meets the daughter she gave away at birth. There's great work from Nicole Kidman as the adoptive mom and from Gwendolyn Christie as an overeager underling. Reader, share this story. http://vtdtar.co2x60q